As NHS waiting lists hit a record high of nearly 7.8 million patients this week, we're giving you direct access to five top medical experts.
So we've got through a lot of good work this week. We've covered heart health, gut health, dermatology. Today we're focusing on women's health.
Yeah, which is huge. You know, 750,000 women are on a waiting list to see a gynaecologist, with some waiting over a year for an appointment.
Oh, my word. The stress waiting a year. Unbelievable.
Today, especially when you're in pain.
Can you imagine? Yeah. Oh, my word. We are joined by gynecologist and women's health expert, Dr. Neetu Bejikal. Good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
You're very, very popular this morning. We've got a phone in coming later on. But
my
we're just going to have a kind of few of the headlines first this morning. But really good to see you. Thanks for giving us your time. Thank you for inviting me.
Dr. Neetu, what are women coming in with? What is the most popular?
Well, I think women's problems have always been put right to the back burner by health professionals and women themselves. But painful periods, endometriosis, incontinence, heavy menstrual bleeding, prolapse are, you know, very common conditions and are often labelled as non-urgent or elective, but they are very urgent. You know, cancer has got a separate pathway, but when you have painful periods which cripple you, can't actually leave the room, can't go to work, prolapse or, you know, urinary incontinence, all these things can really affect the quality of one's life. Right. And being told that it's not urgent and you have to wait for over a year makes me very upset as a gynecologist, and it does my colleagues as well.
And a lot of these issues are very painful for women as well. You know, women are in a lot of pain before they can come and see somebody like yourself.
Absolutely. There are no gold medals to put up with pain, whatever we may have been told, that periods are painful and that's normal because I had it, your grandmother had it. No, periods should not be painful. They should not be stopping you from going about your daily life. Periods should not be so heavy that you're flooding or leaking or actually not are having to use double protection. These things have to be taken seriously. They are not normal, and so it's important to educate your body about yourself, about your body. Make sure that you're aware of these things and actually not take no for an answer.
Yeah.
You mentioned incontinence. Let's start with that. How common is it? What can be done about it?
Most women in their lifetime will have urinary incontinence, but about half of all women will have incontinence on a regular basis. And that can be a number of reasons for this. You know, women may be carrying excess weight. We know we are a heavier nation. Women may also, after pregnancy, after childbirth, during pregnancy, after childbirth, and other medical conditions can all cause you to start leaking when you go to the gym, when you go on a walk, you can't play with your children, you know, on coughing, sneezing can really be embarrassing, actually. And then there is, that's known as stress incontinence. And then there is something called urgency or urge incontinence, where if you are having bladder irritants in high amounts, caffeine, alcohol, and other, you know, recurrent urinary tract infections, all these things can leave you with incontinence that can be very difficult to deal with on a daily basis. And if you're then waiting for a year or two, when there are some things that you can do at home, but you do need to see a specialist pretty quickly and get that help. So we do need much more input. Historically, gynecology has always been left in the back burner. Obstetrics has taken a bit more of the front side, but, you know, women's health does need attention.
And can we talk about endometriosis? Because it's huge. It is a lot of women out there suffering with endometriosis, and I don't think it gets talked about enough.
So I've been doing this for over 40 years. It takes women doctors to diagnose endometriosis anywhere between 7 to 10 years.
No.
That is how long it takes for a woman to get a diagnosis. It breaks my heart.
And so why is that?
It's because, as I said, people are often told periods are... It's normal to have painful periods. It's normal to have heavy periods and that it'll all get better with childbirth. No. Painful periods can be a really important sign of endometriosis. Endometriosis is where the lining of the womb sticks itself outside and can grow and bleed at the same time when you have your menstrual cycle. So it's really important to understand the symptoms because it's a whole body condition. Causes chronic fatigue.
And once you know, if you're looking for it, is it easy to spot?
No, it's because you still have to... So far, we don't have a blood test that picks up endometriosis. There's research going on, but what you need is a procedure like by somebody like myself, a laparoscopy or a keyhole procedure to actually diagnose it. So that obviously needs experts to be able to do that. But you can actually have a good enough idea just from taking a very good clinical history, by doing ultrasound scans, and by actually listening to the patient.
Imagine suffering with this and you're in a waiting list for a year.
Well, it's not that. I know women that are, and the pain that they are going through. I keep mentioning pain because I've seen it from my own eyes, and it's absolutely horrific what these women have to go through.
No gold medals for pain.
No.
You really need... That needs to be addressed. Painful intercourse is another problem. Urinary problems, bowel problems, bloating, all these are symptoms. So often doctors don't join the dots because you're going to see a gastroenterologist, you're going to see different people, and it's really important. Often it's the same condition and it's endometriosis.
Thank you for visiting our This Morning YouTube channel. We upload new content every day. So go ahead, hit that subscribe button. You don't want to miss out, and we'll see you in the morning.